Now we're going to have something a little bit different. I'm going to invite Gary Schofield to come up, and he's going to share some memories, and he's going to lead us in If I Had a Hammer. You should have a sheet, and if you don't have one, if you could please share. Well, I don't know what you're going to do first. Are you going to sit first?
Memories first.
Memories first, okay.
I first met Roy. Is this the volume okay?
Yeah.
Okay, I first met Roy in 1954 when I came to work at National Research Council. And I mean the real National Research Council, the one on Sussex Street, you know, with the big columns and not that collection of huts on Montreal Road. So he was a scientist, I was a lab technician. I had 1 year in at Carleton in physics, and then I decided to get married, and so I had to get a job, and that turned out to be my job, and I worked there for 3.5 years. The scientists there, and I had never met any group of scientists, so I really didn't know anything about it, but they were quite a collection of characters. And the sanest one seemed to be Roy, who was always even-tempered, and it was always Roy that I'd go to when I needed to find out what I had to do or where something was. And he always gave me understandable and practical advice. The other thing that was significant about those days is it turned out that he was a table tennis player. And I was heavy into table tennis. At that point, I used to play at the Y, and with a group of who were the best players in Ottawa, and I did pretty good against them, occasionally winning a game or so. And so we enjoyed that. Much later, of course, we played the table tennis that in the basement of his house on Beaver Hill. But I'll come to that in a minute. So when my time was finished there, and I remember it, I announced that I was going to take a job at the YMCA, and the head of the department, Dr. Middleton, was not very impressed. He says, "Oh well, I suppose somebody has to do that," he said. So I went on and started to work at the YMCA in Ottawa and Quebec City. And then when I came back, Roy got me involved in a table tennis league where we played against other teams and so on. And somewhere in there, I did visit the cottage at Pemashangan a couple of times. In fact, one time I went there by canoe because it was connected to a lake that I had a buddy who had property there. And it was a lot of fun. It was always a lot of fun. And everything that has been said about Roy, about his kindness and his modesty and everything, absolutely true. So all this was fine. I eventually retired from, I had left the Y and started to teach at Algonquin College. I eventually retired there, and Roy got me into playing tennis. He lived right around the corner. He was on Beaver Hill. I was on Ogilvy Road, or just off Ogilvy Road. So he said, "Why don't we play tennis?" So there happened to be a tennis court at the condominium where I was, so we played there. And he had the advantage of having played a lot more, but I was 11 years younger than him, so I had some advantage. And I managed to start winning games when I found a new racket. At that point, they were just coming out with the composite rackets with the oversized head and the big sweet spot. So I gave up my John McEnroe wooden racket with the frame that you had clipped together, you remember those? And got this, and shortly after, Roy saw how well I was doing, so he got one for himself also. And we went from there to a local tennis club and played there for a while, and eventually in the wintertime played at the Ottawa Athletic Club. And it was good fun. And the only time I remember there was any conversation that passed between us with any heat was when we were doubles partners. And partly because of the tournament stuff that I was into, I was very aggressive. I wanted to win every point and as soon as possible. Roy was a little bit gentler, and he would like to, you know, kind of play some sort of strategy. And I remember one time we got frustrated, and I said, "Will you hit the ball? Hit the ball!" And Roy says, "How can I hit the ball when you're yelling at me?" So I got the point. There was no sense in pushing him, so I just shut up and let him do it his way, and it worked out well. The other thing that he got me into was singing with the Unitarian group. And I don't know exactly how that happened. I think we were invited to a house party and did some singing there, and then at other places, and at least once in this hall. And I enjoyed it very much. I knew all the songs from the YMCA camp, and I had a good memory for songs, so I had a kind of a semi-leadership position. But I think I was too religious for the Unitarians, because I liked some of those old spirituals. And I didn't give a darn what the words said. If it was a good song, I sang it. So I remember one time I was singing, "Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray." And Reverend Fred said, "What divinity school did you graduate from?" Anyway, my memories of Roy are very, very fond. He was a wonderful guy in every respect. And thinking about his later, not all the way through, he was involved with various movements. Coalition to Oppose the Arms Trade, and I think there was World Federalists at one point, and maybe some other ones. I remember at his place on Beaver Hill, I was over there, and a visitor was Julian Bond, who later was a senator and had been involved in the Black Rights Movement and later became a senator and much mentioned in the media. So Roy seemed to open the door for many aspects of my life. So in honor of that, I'd like to invite us all to sing "If I Had a Hammer." I see they have the words, I don't have my glasses, so it doesn't matter. All you have to remember is there's a hammer, a bell, and a song in that order. No, it's okay. I've got over this and looked at YouTube and refreshed my memory. Not to say what they're going to say, but anyway.
Can we please rise as you were willing to do?
And we're going to sing. We have no musical instruments to go with, so we're going to sing what I call Archipelago, which means little islands of harmony in a sea of discord. Okay. If I had a hammer,
I'd hammer in the morning, I'd hammer in the evening, all over this land. I'd hammer out danger, I'd hammer out warning, I'd hammer out love between my brothers and my sisters, all over this land. If I had a bell, I'd ring it in the morning, I'd ring it in the evening, all over this land. I'd ring out danger, I'd ring out a warning, I'd ring out love between my brothers and my sisters, all over this land. If I had a song to sing, I'd sing it in the morning, I'd sing it in the evening. brothers and my sisters all over this land.
Well, I have a bell, a hammer,
and I got a bell. It's the hammer of justice, it's the bell of freedom, it's the song of love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land. It's the hammer of justice, it's the bell of freedom, it's the song of love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land.
Thank you, Roy, for sharing, allowing me to share part of your life. And thank you to Roy's family to give me this opportunity to say goodbye to a very dear old